The Union issue 1 finds the old kids' cartoon of Britannia being played, showcasing the hero battling Doc Croc, freeing herself from her bindings and beating the crocodile up with the bricks, stopping his plan to zap all of the energy of Britain's people. Britannia says the crocodile underestimated the defining character of the British people, who are too stubborn to give up. In the present, 10 Downing Street delivers an announcement regarding Brexit and how the country is being pulled apart in different directions, losing faith in its leaders. So now they need a new vision for themselves, which is why they announced the new team led by Britannia. Since if these heroes can come together and unite to defeat a common foe, then perhaps the people of Great Britain can do the same. Britannia and her new team are revealed as at Breendown Fort, Union Jack and the only remaining member of his team grab a flag and race out of the fort, intending on winning the game of capture the flag they are currently playing. On Good Morning TV, the hosts get ready to talk about the Britannia Project, teasing a live cross to the game of capture the flag being played by Union Jack. The hosts talk about voting for a team name as well, throwing out the name Team UK amongst others. Union Jack meanwhile watches on as his teammate is consumed by living water, which is being controlled nearby by Kelpie. Joe demands the unseen hero let the man go, since she is drowning him, so she does, prompting Joe to continue with his mission, vaulting over the fort wall as he comes within sight of the game's finish line on a small island outside the fort. Before he can jump over to the small island, Joe is tackled by Britannia, who wants the man to call it a day. Union Jack tells Tanya that's not happening as he tries to trip the woman up. Tanya decides to play Joe's game, hitting him with her staff, but Union Jack manages to escape, heading down the hill and jumping onto the island and winning. Tanya reminds him that he forgot his flag as she notices the flag is covered with logos of Steve Darwin's company, which angers her. With the game won, Union Jack gives an interview on the morning TV show, saying Britannia was a little busy, so he was asked to step in for her. Member of Parliament Selwyn James joins Joe, appreciating the support the people have for the Britannia Project and how young heroes from all over the nation are coming together to help make the future better for them. Tanya meanwhile confronts Steve for putting logos all over the flag, something she warned him against doing, but Steve says that he's backing this project because of what Britannia represents, but they are living in a new Britain and she needs to wake up to that. Union Jack's soldiers meanwhile confront Britannia's team, calling them all freaks, so the choir uses her powers on one of the men, causing him to kneel over in pain. One of his teammates throws his water bottle at the woman, but Kelpie turns the water into daggers, keeping the soldiers at bay as she asks why they are scared of a little water. The towering snake demands the little men walk away as Union Jack calms everyone down, telling them that they're all on the same side. Steve comes to see Union Jack, wanting a selfie with his new friend, knowing the public love the whole Britannia Project. Joe spies something in the sky above them as suddenly the island is attacked by a symbiote dragon. Britannia races into action in front of all of the cameras, which asks if this would be a good time for an interview. Tanya plunges her sword into the symbiote's neck, cutting its head off and causing her and the dragon to fall hard into the ground. Union Jack rushes to Tanya's aid as the soldiers find the symbiote's head, kicking it as it comes back to life. Joe gets to the injured Tanya, telling her to hold on, but the woman knows nobody is going to fix what has happened to her. Britannia knows that she had a good run as she dies in Union Jack's arms. Joe isn't given a moment to grieve as the symbiote dragon has infected his soldiers, turning them into symbiote warriors, who tell their former leader that now they are not playing games. Grabbing Britannia's sword, Union Jack leads his new team into battle against the symbiotes. The Union issue 1 sees Judge Dredd and Jack's staff writer Paul Grist deliver a wonderfully new and very relevant British-centric team book, kickstarting a new team of British heroes whose first big task is to deal with the King in Black event. Unlike this week's Atlantis Attacks issue, the Union is much more connected to the big Venom event, while also balancing out setting up a new team and its premise, which Paul does very well here, using real-life events like Brexit to fuel the need for a British hero team to help unite the shattered people of Great Britain. The twist with Britannia seemingly dying at the end of the issue was quite shocking, seeing as that she's on the front cover, sort of like the face of the team, and I think it'd be quite interesting if that was actually something to stick around, since it means Union Jack having to end up lead the team, which would be cool, seeing as this issue sets him up as kind of like a corporate shield type hero. So it would be cool to have a great way to kickstart a story for him to remember why he became a hero and make him a better man. I'm looking looking forward to seeing the team's role in the King in Black event and what will happen to them after the big event wraps up. Will they stick around? Will they disband? I'm intrigued to find out. I'm going to give this issue an 8.5 out of 10.